Hi, I'm Mike Massimino.
I'm Don Pettit.
And welcome to the
Inside ISS Mailbag.
Okay, now I'm going to put myself in ham radio mode because only have a 10-minute pass, and we'll have 20 to 30 kids, and you don't want to leave some kids out.
Oh, so we're going to go quick.
All
right, we're in the, what do you call it, the lightning round.
Yes.
Got the egg timer?
Go ahead.
From Jeffrey Taylor, has anyone considered designing a record player with an arm and a needle which can compensate for zero G? Short answer, no. Is there always a Dr. McCoy dedicated for medical help? No, they teach us if we don't have a doctor, we run through emergency medical training.
Right, and even if you do have a doctor, he may need help.
Yes.
So you got to know how to help each other. On the shuttle flight, so we had one medical officer and then kind of like a one or two assistants that went through the heavy medical training. On ISS, everyone's got to go through it.
Okay, right? Okay, from Nick. And it says, what's going through your head right before liftoff?
Maybe this wasn't such a good idea. How about for you?
You're focused on your mission. You're focused on what's going to happen to keep your rocket happy so you can get into space. And then once you get into space, then you can think about the ambiance of being in space.
Right.
Okay. Here's one. New Year discount, $20 off. No, that's not it. Okay. Is there any place you would like to visit on the ground that you saw from space? I'd like to go to the Atacama Desert.
Where is that?
It's in Chile. It's a high altitude desert. It's great for doing amateur astronomy.
Right.
And the neat thing is you can be up there and you can see both the north and the south southern hemisphere stars at the same time and still be on Earth.
Nice. I would like to go. I've been to a lot of cool places, I guess, but I've never been to Antarctica. Seems like a cool place to go to.
You only see southern sky in Antarctica.
Yeah, you didn't get to see much of it. I've never been to Australia. How's that? I've never been to Australia. You have.
Okay, now here's one from...
We spent a lot of time flying over Australia.
From Saucy1. Saucy1 says, okay, weird question. Can you transport champagne into space? And if so, how does ISS gravity what does it do to it when it's uncorked? Well, I've never seen champagne in space or even any
research proposal right there.
Hey, research grade champagne. I wonder if you could get that. But anyway, I've never seen champagne in space. If you did happen to uncork it, I think I have a good idea what would happen.
What's going
to
happen?
Think rocket engine.
Kaboom. It's going to be propulsive.
It will be propulsive because the pressure will decrease, the gas will come out of solution, homogeneous bubble nucleation, and which means the volume of the liquid gas is going to be greater than the bottle, and so it's going to squirt out. It'll be a rocket engine.
All right.
It'll make a mess.
So like carbonated soft drinks?
Out of the question.